Tonight is a very special night. It's not only to celebrate the holidays, but it's a triumphant return of this kind of program roadtrip. It's been over 2 years that we missed you. And tonight, we're going to open the presents. We're going to have a little bit of fun with Christmas and surprises. And this is the first of two episodes that you're not going to believe. So stick around, because music, telling, and a tree lighting are all awesome. Stick around from Palmer Square here in the beautiful heart of Princeton, New Jersey. I'm Ron Wanted, and believe it or not, it's the start of season 9 of Broadway.
1 month we haven't talked to you from this. Because I want to say thank you first of all for being patient. Thank you for being loyal to our Rosa fans and watching us on Brooklyn Free Speech 1. And we'd like to thank everybody on YouTube. And he said, you really missed me so much. It's good to be back again. All the rest of us, yeah, man, yeah. Crazy stuff. Our broken down consumers. It's good to be back here and each and every one of you. I'm very happy you're back again. And by the way, today we're going to kick off season 9. We're going to celebrate Christmas. And the reason why we're going
to
do this probably
Michael wanted to go in there.
Here's the two paintings that I've been doing. And I'm going to show you the Christmas market that I've been doing. And on Sunday, the whole thing gets the party for 1 hour. And I mean 1 full hour. Christmas, telling, music, and everything else. So before we stick around. And by the way, on top of everything, the previous what lies ahead in 2024. That's a little bit later in the show. But right now, here to kick things off right now, our Mets band is just fantastic, and they are tearing down the place like hell, and they love it. Here they are, with some of the, couple of their favorite songs. Here are Soul.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the one I used to know. Thank you.
first, just leaving the house was hard.
But Wounded Warrior Project helps you realize it's possible to get out there.
To feel a sense of camaraderie again.
To find the tools to live life better.
Through generous community support, we've connected warriors and their families with no-cost physical and mental health services, legislative advocacy, career assistance, and life skill training for 20 years. And we're just getting started.
COVID-19 has caused more than 1 million deaths in the United States alone. But right now, there are steps we can all take to protect ourselves and our relatives from severe illness and even death. If you feel sick, stay home if at all possible and get tested. If you must go out in the public, continue to wear a mask and keep a 6-foot distance from others at all times. Vaccines and now boosters continue to be a safe and effective tool for helping to stop the spread of this deadly virus. This message was brought to you by the Great Plains Tribal Epidemiology Center, so that the people may live.
Folks, welcome back to the Road Trip. It's our special Christmas episode. We're having a great time here at the fantastic Commerce Square here in downtown Christmas. This is our favorite. And it's also our triumphant return to our show. You can't be missing. But I got Soul Cruisers with me today. They are a terrific soul band. And we're going to show you. Tell us who you are.
My name is Gabe.
Oh, yeah, I got to say my look first than that.
Really?
Rod Anthony Runs? Yeah.
Oh,
right!
Yeah.
Cool. Right. So Rod Anthony Runs, ladies and gentlemen.
That's right.
Now tell us about this terrific band.
They've been together for about 35 years, doing R&B soul and Motown all over all this area here, all over the United States.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're ready to go international, that's the whole thing.
Oh, all right, and you got a lot of good places coming up very soon for 2024. Yes, indeed. And what is the most important about keeping this band together as a soulful, terrific sound?
One of the things that we all have in common is that we love old school music and the feeling of what it brings.
Yeah.
And the amazing thing about our fans, when they come to see us, they always, everyone seems to know all the words of these songs. These songs, you know, Motown, Spitters, and even some of the 60s and 70s.
Oh, yeah. I love it way back when
way back
kids.
Stuff, you know, when, you know, Expressway.
Yeah.
All these kinds of songs, it's great to be able to do that. And not only gives us a chance to sing it to people who know the song, but introduce it to like young people.
Absolutely. And we got a lot of young people with us today. That's very nice about it. You know, back when I was growing up, I was looking for soul music the first time, and then there was a first station that called WWR. It was the old one in New York.
Reggie Crocker.
Oh, yeah. Frankie Crocker, Al Atkins, Hank Stan, Jerry Butts. That's one of my favorite guys. I love it. And not to mention Chuck Berry.
That's right.
He's one of my mom wants to talk to him.
Really?
Yeah. Wow. Because he worked for me at Rockland Center.
Oh, okay.
God bless him. Anyway, so we're going to see you perform coming up in just a few minutes.
I keep all the pretty girls out there, by the man who's after me. You were super duper today, getting your COVID vaccine, Elmo.
Yeah, there was a little pinch, but it was okay. Elmo was really glad to have Daddy and Baby David there with him. Baby David, where are you?
I had a lot of questions about Elmo getting the COVID vaccine. Was it safe? Was it the right decision? I talked to our pediatrician so I could make the right choice. I learned that Elmo getting vaccinated is the best way to keep himself, our friends, neighbors, and everyone else healthy and enjoying the things they love.
Oh, Daddy! Oh, Elmo and Baby David have a question. Oh. Can we have a hug?
Oh, come here, son.
Elmo loves you, Daddy.
I love you, too.
It's okay to have questions about COVID vaccines for your kids. Get the latest facts by speaking to your pediatrician or healthcare provider.
Mom, why is there stuff out here?
Hey, can't stay here.
Okay.
Jamie, look who's joined us this evening. We've got Clara and the Snow Queen from the American Repertory Ballet.
Well, hello.
Hi, welcome, I'm Leah. Girls. I'm dressed as Clara from the Nutcracker, and my favorite part about the holiday season is spending time with my family.
Hi, I'm Gigi, and I'm dressed as the Snow Queen, and my favorite part about the holiday season are the dazzling decorations and spending time with loved ones.
Please enjoy some scenes from American Repertory Ballet's Nutcracker,
along with some backstage footage and highlights from Princeton Ballet School and our organization.
Tonight is the perfect time to share with all of you here in Palmer Square my favorite Christmas Eve story. It was Christmas Eve at the Silver House home. Clara and her little brother Fritz were listening at the ballroom door, waiting for the party to begin. Everyone was dancing when the last guest arrived. "Godfather," cried Clara, rushing back to greet him. Uncle Drosselmeyer was not only Clara's godfather, but he was also a famous toy maker. He could make toys that moved and clocks that called the hours as sweetly as the nightingale. Drosselmeyer brought presents for the children. He gave Fritz a box of toy soldiers. For Clara, there were two dolls, a Harlequin and Columbine, who danced with each other. "I have another present for you, Clara," said Drosselmeyer, and handed her a wooden Nutcracker soldier. "I want you to take good care of him." "Not fair," shouted Fritz. "She has three presents." He grabbed the Nutcracker from Clara and tossed him in the air. The Nutcracker crashed to the ground and broke his head. Drosselmeyer wrapped the Nutcracker's head with his handkerchief, and Clara took the Nutcracker into her arms. Outside on the street, the carriages waited. After a flurry of goodbyes to their many guests, Fritz and Clara were sent up to bed. "But my poor Nutcracker is all alone," thought Clara, and she tiptoed back downstairs to find her Nutcracker under the tree. Holding the Nutcracker close, she soon fell asleep. Drosselmeyer slipped into the room and raised his hand, cast a bit of magic. Bong, bong, bong. The grandfather clock struck midnight. Clara stirred and rubbed her eyes. The Christmas tree was growing. Around her came a scampering of mice. Squeak, squeak, They were gathering around their Rat King like an army ready to attack. Clara held the Nutcracker and ran as fast as she could. To help with the battle. He raised his hand and the Nutcracker was transformed into a handsome prince. The prince bowed to Clara and placed the Rat King's sparkling crown upon her head. Come, said the prince, and they walked through falling snowflakes to a waiting boat that flew them through the night. Clara and the prince traveled to the land of sweets and were greeted by the sugar plum fairy. The prince told the story of the great battle and how Clara saved the day by hurting the Mouse King and securing victory. The sugar plum fairy led the prince and Clara to the seat of honor. As a reward for Clara's heroism, the sugar plum fairy presented dances from all the different lands, including chocolate from Spain, coffee from Arabia, tea from China, candy canes from Russia, marzipan from Germany, and a wonderfully playful meeting of Mother Ginger and her naughty children. A fragrant bouquet of flowers waltzed for them, and a pas de deux was danced by the sugar plum fairy and her cavalier. After the grand finale, Uncle Drosselmeyer returned, and a very happy but tired Clara home to the comfort of her family parlor. She awakened from her journey, and upon seeing her beloved Nutcracker doll, wondered if it was all a dream.
To make lasting friendships with people I still keep in touch with today.
Because of camp, I learned about self-esteem.
Because of camp, I play guitar.
I learned to be a team player.
I learned about diversity.
Because of camp, I am sending my kids to camp this summer.
I learned how to play guitar, I learned how to canoe, I learned how to fish.
I learned that I was the best Tarzan yeller in the camp.
Because of camp, I became a counselor.
I learned how to take care of the environment.
Because of camp, I learned to navigate the world.
I was good in school for a whole year so that I could go back to camp.
Because of camp, I got a personality. Now I'm...
Because of camp, I turned out just fine.
Wounded Warrior Project has been with me every step of my journey.
Aaron,
with experiences that help me realize that I'm not alone.
And specialized programs that give me the tools to train my body and mind.
Now, it's possible for me to get back out there.
To get out of my comfort zone and try new things.
To build and be part of a community that supports other warriors.
It's possible to get the help I need for me and my family.
I got my confidence back. I'm setting goals and I'm achieving them.
It's possible to feel understood. Whether it's day one or 20 years down the road, they've got your back.
And as each warrior's needs evolve, Wounded Warrior Project is adapting to meet them.
Because when we pull together,
it's possible to go further than you ever imagined.
Hi, I'm Michelle Yeoh. As an actress, I've been in many dangerous situations on screen, but I always get to walk away. In real life, though, most people don't. So when you're in your car, follow these safe steps and help save lives. The numbers don't lie. Seat belts save lives. Everyone should always wear a seat belt. Passengers who don't wear seat belts are a danger to themselves and others. In a crash, they can be thrown around the car, causing serious injury. Ensure children are safely fastened into car seats suitable for their size and weight, and keep small children out of the front seat. We all have a role in road safety. Follow these safe steps and play your part. For more road safety advice, visit safesteps.com.
COVID-19 has caused more than 1 million deaths in the United States alone. But right now, there are steps we can all take to protect ourselves and our relatives from severe illness and even death. If you feel sick, stay home if at all possible and get tested. If you must go out in the public, continue to wear a mask and keep a 6-foot distance from others at all times. Vaccines and now boosters continue to be a safe and effective tool for helping to stop the spread of this deadly virus. This message was brought to you by the Great Plains Tribal Epidemiology Center, so that the people may live.
I was surprised how easy it was to get a good, low-cost health plan.
Choose yours today. You might even get help paying for yours.
Go to nystateofhealth.ny.gov or call 1-855-355-5777.
So, same time next week?
Well, of course. For free tips to help you save, go to
Feed the Pig.
All right, folks, welcome back to Real Talk. Well, we hope you enjoy our pre-Christmas show for this Friday.
With some great music, talent, sometimes some surprises in there.
Well, let me tell you something. We are not done yet. We'll be back Sunday night, 11 p.m. Eastern, right here on our sister channel, Brooklyn 363. We'll have the whole hour. This music is going to be a lot of fun to check out. So, please, we're going to be back with us again. So, Princeton High School Choir will be here. Of course, we got Santa going to be here. Amazing. The carolers will be back as well. We have a great evening of fun, music, young, and it's just 1 hour of this season. It's going to start right here at 11 p.m. this coming Sunday night on Brooklyn Street. And don't forget not to mention this one. Join us for Game Show Block Party tomorrow late night, 1 to 1:30 a.m. Brooklyn Free Speech 3, and also at 12:30 to 1 and over on Manhattan.
and there was Lifestyle Channel 2 at 2 o'clock on Tuesday. And Dander Video Game Series will be about 15 and a half hours from now. We'll be at 3:30 p.m. It's video games itself. And by the way, congratulations to R. Kirk and Dander here. They're both.
Hello, it's me.
I forgot to bring my cell phone with me. All right, that's it for tonight. Hope you enjoyed the show. We'll see you in approximately 47 hours, 1 minute, and 15 seconds for right now.
Thank you so much.
And we'll join you on our sister channel, Brooklyn Free Speech 3, for our Christmas Eve episode of Roast. In the meantime, Sci-Fi Ninja Crew is coming up next. We'll see you then. Until Sunday night, Christmas Eve, I'm Ron Roddick. And as always, always keep the faith. So long, bye-bye, bye-bye, and we'll leave you. Good. We wish you a Merry Christmas music from the Princeton High School Choir. We'll see you Sunday night.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish